When things go wrong during police vehicular chases, the carnage is big news. In the past there were enough dashcam images from disastrous law enforcement pursuits to fill seasons of cheap, sensationalized TV shows, while live footage from helicopters made for some of the highest-rated shows on Los Angeles stations. But things are changing. Almost all U.S. law enforcement agencies have adopted a restrictive pursuit policy, according to the International Association of Chiefs of Police. Much to the dismay of TV executives, most cops will no longer conduct long chases that start when the officer tries to pull a motorist over for a broken tail light, though cops still chase suspected felons and other serious bad guys. Before restrictive pursuit policies, often the worst thing that officers found at the end of a chase was a suspended license, an ashtray full of seeds and stems, or empty beer cans in the pickup bed. Now, many law enforcement agencies have decided that it's not worth the danger when such chases could cause the death of the suspect, an officer, or an innocent. Let's take a step back in time. From the 1980s until early in this century, almost 350 people died during police pursuits each year. More than 30% of those were innocent bystanders. And about one-third of all pursuits ended in a wreck. We should note that these statistics are fuzzy. Cops don't like to tattle on themselves or each other. A nonprofit group called Pursuit Safety, dedicated to reducing deaths resulting from police chases, ignores government reports in its own research because it says the data is incomplete. Few who flee the police are violent felons. Instead, they are usually 20-something males with bad driving records. A classic California Highway Patrol study from the early 1980s showed that just 5% of those who fled from Highway Patrol officers had been charged with an armed offense previously, and just 0.3% had been convicted. And when chases end badly, taxpayers foot the bill for a multi-million-dollar ruling in court, workers' compensation costs from injured officers, and replacing expensive cruisers. Will limited pursuit policies cause more drivers to flee, knowing police regulations restrict high-speed pursuits? An IACP study found no evidence to support that. Also, interviews people who have fled from the police, conducted by the National Institute of Justice, revealed that the offenders returned to normal driving within about 90 seconds of the chases being abandoned. And cops are learning to live with restraint. "We'll get them next time," an Illinois State Police officer told me. "They'll screw up again soon enough."